Hello learners, my name is Dr. Priya Mahajan. In our previous session of foreign investments, we have discussed about the need for foreign investments, factors influencing foreign investments, and the benefits of foreign investments. In this session, we will discuss about the different types of foreign investments and through which modes these investments are made in the host country. So, in this diagram, we can see that the foreign investments can be classified into foreign direct investments and foreign portfolio investments. Foreign portfolio investments are investments in the financial securities on the stock exchanges of a foreign country. Learners, in this video, I will take an example of India as a host country who get investments from international market. Foreign portfolio investments can be made through GDRs, that is Global Depository Receipts, ADRs, American Depository Receipts, FCCBs, foreign currency convertible bonds issued by Indian issuers or companies to raise funds from the international market. Besides that, foreign institutional investors can also make investments in the Indian securities. First, we will discuss about the GDRs and how GDRs work. I will try to explain you in a simple term through this diagram. A GDR or Global Depository Receipt is a bank certificate issued in one country for shares in another country. Say you are an Indian company that wants to raise capital from outside India. How would you sell your equity shares directly to overseas investors, or you can say foreign investors? Learners, you approach a depository bank which is based overseas. The Indian company issues shares to the depository bank, and that depository bank issues receipts or certificate or instruments known as depository receipts or DRs. These receipts are then issued as shares by this authorized overseas depository bank in its domestic stock exchange, from where the investors can buy and trade. This means they trade like domestic shares in that country, even though they belong to an Indian company. And investors can purchase them in an international marketplace. So, the depository bank is essentially a financial intermediary which act as the custodian of the shares issued by the Indian company. Global Depository Receipts or GDRs thus provide a simplified mechanism for buying shares, for buying and trading shares of foreign companies. So now, in formal terms, GDRs are negotiable certificates issued by depository banks that represent ownership of a specified number of a company's shares. These receipts can be listed and traded independently from the underlying shares. With the GDRs, foreign companies can trade in any country's stock market except the US stock market. Those holding GDRs can convert them into shares by surrendering the receipts to the depository bank. They are listed on non-US stock exchanges like the London Stock Exchange or the Luxembourg Stock Exchange. The GDR market is an institutional one and hence offers less liquidity but allows trading across a more significant number of countries. For example, if Infosys want to list its share in Australia, they will deposit a substantial number of shares with an Australian bank. The bank can then issue receipts, that is called GDRs, against these shares to investors. Each receipt represents a particular number of shares. Companies planning to issue GDR need to seek prior approval of the Ministry of Finance and Foreign Investment Promotion Board, that is FIPB. Examples of companies that have issued GDRs in India include Aditya Birla Capital Limited, listed in the Luxembourg Stock Exchange, GAIL Indian is listed in the London Stock Exchange, UPL is listed on the Singapore Exchange. Next financial instrument is American Depository Receipts, ADRs. ADRs are used by Indian companies to raise funds in the US market only, and they are denominated in US dollars. ADRs is a negotiable instrument which is issued by US depository bank, which represent the non-US company stock that is being traded in the US stock exchange. Indian companies are able to trade in the US stock market through this financial instrument. They are listed in American stock exchange such as New York Stock Exchange and NASDAQ. The whole procedure to issue ADRs are same as of GDRs. SEBI came out with a detailed framework for issue of depository receipts, DRs, in October 2019. As per the new amended rules, DRs can be issued by way of public offering, private placement, or in a manner that is accepted in the concerned jurisdiction. Usually, most companies from India follow the GDR route due to the more stringent accounting norms, disclosures, and other regulatory requirements involved in the US law compliant ADRs. Then there are foreign currency convertible bonds, that is FCCBs. Foreign currency convertible bonds are bonds issued by Indian companies and subscribed by a non-resident in foreign currency. They carry a fixed interest or coupon rate and are convertible into ordinary shares of issuing company at a preferred price. These bonds are listed and traded abroad. Interest paid on these bonds is in dollars, and if the holder did not exercise the conversion option, the redemption is also made in dollars. Thus, foreign investors prefer FCCBs, whereas Indian companies prefer to issue GDRs. The interest rate is low, but exchange risk is more in foreign currency convertible bonds, as interest is payable in foreign currency. Only companies with the low debt equity ratios and large forex earning potential choose FCCBs to raise funds from international market. Companies intending to raise funds from abroad through the issue of GDRs and foreign currency convertible bonds will need to obtain prior permission of the Department of Economic Affairs, Ministry of Finance, Government of India. So these are the financial instruments used to raise funds from the foreign market. Another means to raise funds or get investments are foreign institutional investors, that is called FIIs. Foreign institutional investors are those institutional investors which invest in the assets belonging to a different country other than that where these organizations are based. Foreign institutional investors play a very important role in any economy. These are the big companies such as investment banks, mutual funds, insurance companies, etc., who invest considerable amount of money in the Indian markets. With the buying of securities by these big players, markets trend to move upward and vice versa. After the reforms of 1991, Indian companies were allowed to raise equity from the international market. Earlier, only debt can be raised from the international markets. In the 1990s, there was a foreign exchange crunch and the government was unable to meet the import requirements of the Indian companies. Hence, allowing Indian companies to tap international market seemed a more sensible option. This permission encouraged Indian companies to become global. So the company who wants to raise international funds has to take into consideration the factors like the size of the issue, the market where the securities to be issued, the price of the issue, and many more other formalities. So this is about the foreign portfolio investments. Another type of investment is foreign direct investment. Foreign direct investment, FDI, is very much concerned with the operation and ownership of the host depository firm. These include wholly owned subsidiary, joint ventures, acquisitions. Wholly owned subsidiary is a separate independent legal entity which is 100% owned and controlled by other company, that is called parent company, and directly works under the guidance and discussion and decision making of the parent company. It has its own senior management to control the business operation of the company. However, all the strategic decisions at the group level are being taken by the parent company only. This is the most transparent and viable way to invest in the country. The wholly owned subsidiary will receive all the funds from parent company. Foreign companies already established in their home country, where they are registered and looking to grab the investment opportunity in India, can do so by setting up a wholly owned subsidiary in India. For example, Starbucks Japan is the wholly owned subsidiary of Starbucks Corporation. So next is joint ventures. When two or more firms join together to create a new business entity that is legally separate and distinct from its parents, joint ventures are established as corporations and owned by the funding partners in the predetermined proportions. American Motor Corporation entered into a venture with Beijing Automotive Works called Beijing Jeep to enter Chinese market by producing jeeps and other vehicles. Joint ventures involved shared ownership. Joint ventures are common in international business. Joint ventures provide required strength in terms of required capital, latest technology, required human talent, etc., and enable the companies to share the risk in the foreign markets. Joint ventures involve the local companies. This act improves the local image in the host country and also satisfies the government requirements regarding the joint ventures. Next is mergers and acquisitions. A domestic company selects a foreign company and merges itself with a foreign company in order to enter international business. Alternatively, the domestic company may purchase the foreign company and acquires its ownership and control. Domestic business select this mode of entering international business as it provides immediate access to international manufacturing facilities and marketing network. Otherwise, the domestic company faces serious problem in gaining access to international market. For example, Coca-Cola entered Indian market instantly by acquiring the Parle and its bottling units. In addition, the domestic company, through this strategy of mergers and acquisition, may also get access to new technology or a patent right. And besides that, there are other ways of foreign direct investments, that is, opening up of branches, franchise holders, turnkey projects, etc. So, this is all about foreign investments and how different types foreign investments can be raised by host companies or countries. So this is all for today's session. Thank you and happy learning.